gym?
My name is Susan Davies. I've been coming to the gym for about 14 weeks and I'm 39.
Well, tell us, why did you start coming to the gym? Tell us a little bit about what's been going on.
Well, I was diagnosed with cancer and I went through a radical hysterectomy and chemotherapy and radiotherapy combined. And I thought, well, the NHS has spent so much money getting me back together. I thought, I don't want them to spend any more on me. I want myself to get fitter and stuff so that I wouldn't be a strain on them again if I could help it.
So obviously you know, for the last year you've been in remission. Tell us, you know, when you got that news, how did that make you feel? And did that really inspire you to want to come in and do something like this?
Yeah, it did, because sometimes there's not light at the end of the tunnel, and fortunately for me there was, and I've come across that journey now. So the next one is I want to get fitter around with the place like this, and Kerry's inspiration. I've got everything here.
Well, tell us about the gym then. What is it about this particular place that you like and that makes you come back here?
It's friendly, it's motivated. It doesn't feel like you're doing a gym session, because everything changes. We get like a 3-week plan and then it changes again, so it doesn't become monotonous.
So what is it that you want to get out of this exactly then? What is it, what's going to drive you on here?
Oh, Kerry, he's an inspiration to anyone, and he gives you a strength and courage, and he is to determination. You just, it's all around the gym, and you want to do well for yourself but also for him.
And what do you think you're going to get out of the exercise and just doing something physical like this?
Because you're going to get fitter mentally and you know, physically, and it puts you in good stead for the rest of the day.
And how important is it, given what you've gone through, how important is this for you physically, mentally?
It's all, and you can see yourself achieving goals, and it just encourages you to give that little bit extra.
And again, with your background, as the men or women who were given the awful news that you were given, and you must have thought at some point, I'm never going to be able to exercise again. Tell us what went through your mind and how you turned it around.
Well, the first thing is to survive. And when you, it's physical at the first thing, because it's just going through it on your mind. And do you live every day for the next, going through treatment, and you know, what are they going to throw at you next? But once you've come over that hurdle, and it's more in your head that you're fighting with, and coming here, it just makes that what bit in your head go. If it sounds mad, but because you're doing something and it takes your mind off things and gives you a more positive attitude.
So if someone else was in the position you were in, what would you say to them?
Fight for yourself, and there's always light at the end of the tunnel, and you've just got to dig in there, and sometimes it's really hard, but if you don't fight for yourself, you ain't gonna go. You're just not going to get anywhere.
Well, you've been coming here for 12 weeks. Is this a long-term thing now for you?
Hopefully.
What do you see?
Yeah, hopefully. I see a new me from coming here. And I wish I'd found this place years ago.
And do you think it will really, really change your life?
Yes. Because Kerry, he's by your side. He gives you inspiration. You know, whether there's 40 people in the gym or one, he's still the same, encouraging you, you know, how much you've got left in the tank, and, you know, inspiring you to do as best as you can.
And how does it make you feel? Do you feel, are you proud of yourself?
Yeah. And the encouragement you get of Kerry just makes you want to do it even more. And, you know, I've achieved one goal by surviving. And you know, this is my next target.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Lovely answer.
Oh my God.